Jedi Jack Penguin, and today I'm bringing you another thoughts video. So today I'm going to be looking at the LEGO Summer 2019 catalog. One thing that's very disappointing, however, about this catalog is that we will not be looking at some of the LEGO Summer 2019 sets as they aren't released in the US yet. Some of these themes include the LEGO Harry Potter theme that will be releasing on July 1st only at Barnes & Noble and LEGO stores, including LEGO Architecture, LEGO Classic, LEGO Creator 3-in-1 sets, LEGO DC Comics Superheroes Batman theme, LEGO Duplo, LEGO Friends, LEGO Hidden Side, LEGO Jurassic World, and LEGO Ninjago sets, which will all be releasing in August, minus some LEGO City sets that will be releasing in both August and a little bit in June, towards the end of the month. Otherwise, those are some of the themes that you will not be seeing within this catalog. One thing to note is that I'm very excited to get those LEGO Harry Potter sets, and I will be getting those day one. You guys can expect a haul video featuring those, but otherwise, let's just get right into this catalog and look at what we actually get within this month. Looking at the front of the magazine, we have Explore Space, Create History right here, which this is the LEGO Apollo 11 Lunar Lander set right here, which this is a really cool looking set. This has been made to celebrate 50 years of the Apollo mission to the moon. We also get our free gift right here on the bottom right there featuring the free space ride with purchases over $100. You can see that also over here on the side. Taking a quick look at that, that is a fan-created model from LEGO Ideas. Pretty interesting that they actually made this like a promotional item. I won't be getting it, however, but you know, it's just something really cool that LEGO has made. But then, continuing on with our little space theme, we have the NASA Apollo Saturn V set right here, which did come out back in last year, I believe, which that retails for $119.99. Really cool set. I actually really like both of these sets that we have right here. I do actually have plans of eventually getting the NASA Apollo 11 Lunar Lander, but I don't know when that'll probably happen. I do really like how that overall looks. You get the American flag in there as well as two astronauts, which, I mean, the one thing that's a little disappointing about them is that they aren't like the actual Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong minifigures, which I think should have been what they did, but, you know, they just gave us plain minifigures for that, which, you know, I guess that's just because of licensing and whatnot. And for $100, I definitely think that set is worth it. And also, as of this time, you can also stack the promotions of the exclusive Rocket Ride set that you get for spending $100 on this set, as well as the patch that you get exclusively with this set if your store still has it. Otherwise, we do have a lot of other themes within this catalog as well, so let's continue moving on within those themes. Looking at our next theme, we have all of the 20 years of LEGO Star Wars sets, which, as you know, I do own all of these sets and have reviewed all of them, as well as done a collection video featuring all of the sets featured on these pages. So I don't really think there's any need for me to talk about these anymore, but, you know, they're just featured within the catalog. I do really like how these pictures look for the sets, which is very nice. We do have the regular wave of LEGO Star Wars sets that released alongside those, which we have the Duel on Starkiller Base. That's a set that I'm still considering getting. That's $20. You can probably find that cheaper as of this time as well. We have the Action Battle Hoth Generator Attack set. Don't really care for it. Same thing goes for the two Star Wars Resistance sets, which I haven't really been following the show, so I don't really care about these, and the prices on them definitely look very bad in my opinion. I think that they could have been a little cheaper, especially this one. Just, it should have been like maybe like 20 bucks at most. And then we have the Major Von Regg's TIE Fighter set, which includes the General Leia, as well as the main characters. We have the Action Battle Echo Base Defense set, which I think that's a little too expensive. I mean, it's just another little Hoth thing that they just decided to toss in for us. Moving forward, we have the Death Star set, which this is the remastered version that came out back in 2017. That's $500 to get that set. I do not own it. I own the original one. I'm currently working on taking apart my original one and putting it back together and dusting it and whatnot, and I might have a review for that before the end of the year, hopefully. Then we have the UCS Millennium Falcon set, which, as you know, I do own that set. I don't know if I'll ever be doing a review on that. That's a very cool, awesome $800 set. It should be retiring soon, so I suggest getting one as soon as possible before they increase in price. We do get a little bit of a Legoland advertisement right here in the middle of the catalog, which that is front and back, and we also have the Lego Movie World that they actually have made, which actually looks pretty cool. As well as you can look at the set display for the Lego Movie 2, which is also pretty cool that they have that within the Legoland Florida Resort as well. Moving forward, we have the Tantive IV, which, as you know, I do really, really want to get this set, but, you know, Lego has been producing a lot of new sets over the past couple months. It's been very hard to actually keep up with all of these new releases. I do really like this set. We do get a new Princess Leia, as well as some Rebel Troopers, as well as R2-D2, C-3PO, our first Bail Organa minifigure, which I think is very nice. And also, I just missed out on this in the first place, so it's very nice for $200 to get that set. It's on my to-get list eventually. Very nice looking set. And then we have the Darth Vader's castle underneath it. That set, as you know, released back in 2018, a little bit early for 2019, which is an Amazon exclusive. It's a cool looking set, I admit. You know, I definitely really like the interior and the exterior for the set, and then you get a small Darth Vader TIE fighter. Though for $129.99, I don't really think I'm ever going to be getting this anytime soon. Moving forward, we have a little bit of LEGO Creator 3-in-1 stuff. We have the futuristic flyer and the shuttle transporter, some space-themed stuff going on right there, very nice. Nothing too interesting that we haven't already seen before. We have some LEGO Overwatch sets. We have the Watchpoint Gibraltar, which I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. That's a $90 LEGO Overwatch set that I probably will never get. I actually really like the design of the ship, but you know, I don't really care for it overall. Then we have the Tracer vs. Widowmaker set, which was one of the first LEGO Overwatch sets that I got back in 2018 when I found them early at my local Walmart. You guys can check out my review for that down in the description below or the card above. Moving on, we have some modular buildings. We have the Downtown Diner set, very nice set. We have the Assembly Square, we have the Corner Garage, which I don't know if I've ever talked about that before. I don't remember if I actually looked at that within a previous catalog or not, but pretty nice looking set, but probably something I will never get. Then we have the Parisian Restaurant, which, as you know, I do own that one modular building. Moving on, we have some other bigger sets right here. We have the Volkswagen T1 Camper Van, as well as the Volkswagen Beetle. I really like the designs of some of these bigger cars, but as you know, I do not have the money to afford any of these sets. I do really like the Volkswagen Beetle, though. We have the Ford Mustang, which looks pretty nice, as well as the London bus right there. Pretty cool. Very nice inclusion within the LEGO world. Then we have some other bigger sets right here. We have the Vestas Wind Turbine set, something that nobody really asked for a remake of, as well as the Taj Mahal, which is a remake from the previous version. We also have the roller coaster set right up there and the carousel, some pretty cool looking sets that I'll probably never own unless I find them very cheap at a yard sale. Then we can move on to the LEGO Movie 2. We have Benny's Space Squad and the Ultra Caddy and Warrior Lucy sets, which I own both of those sets and have reviews for them up on the channel. You can check them out in the description below or the card above. We also have the Emmett and Lucy's Escape Buggy right there, which is a set that I probably will never get. Same thing goes for the Welcome to Apocalypseburg set, which I think is probably one of the stronger LEGO Movie 2 sets. I actually really, really want to get this set since it looks very cool, and I've seen a lot of people review it and everything, and it just looks like a very beautiful set, and it includes a lot of very nice exclusive minifigures. Otherwise, that's pretty much all my thoughts for that. $300 set, pretty cool looking set. Moving on, we have some of the newer LEGO Movie 2 sets that released in May, which I do not own any of these. We have the Shimmer and Shine Sparkle Spa set, which is the only set so far to include the vampire characters in there, as well as a lot of very cool looking brick built characters. I don't know if I'm ever gonna get that set. $70 is a little too expensive for my taste. Then we have the Queen Whatever is So Not Evil Space Palace for $100, which I'm probably not going to get this set. It looks very interesting, but it's something that I don't really care for. Moving on, we have the Rexelsior, which is something that, you know, I've been looking at for a while. $150 for this set is definitely worth it. You get some exclusive minifigures, and, you know, even though it's a micro scale set, I just think it looks very cool, and also, like, you can hold it like a fist, and, like, it just looks really cool. I don't know if I'm ever gonna get it, but, you know, it's on my to-get list eventually if I ever find it on my clearance or something. Same thing goes for the Emmett's Triple Decker Couch Mech, which I'm probably gonna end up getting that eventually. $30 for that set. I almost got it at my local Target a little bit early, but then they street dated it on me, which was a little disappointing. This is a set that I really want to get since I do own the original double decker couch set, and this is also just very interesting since it is a 2-in-1 with the mech and just the triple decker couch itself, and a very nice Unikitty minifigure in there as well. Moving on, we have some stuff from LEGO Technic right here, which, you know, as you know, I don't really care for LEGO Technic. We have a lot of pullback as well as 2-in-1 sets going on right here. Nothing too fancy that I really care about. We will be getting some more Technic sets in August. Then we have some other more realistic Technic cars right here, which I don't really care for these as well. I did enter a giveaway to win one of these. Hopefully I win it or I don't win it. I don't really care. Then we have some other Technic related cars, 2-in-1, and then another bigger one. We have some LEGO Marvel sets right here. We have some of the Spider-Man Far From Home sets, which I think this is the first time that I'm really covering these. We have the Hydro Man Attack, which is really like the only set that I really care about within this Spider-Man wave, other than the minifigure pack that did release back a couple days ago on June 1st, which for some reason isn't included within this catalog. This set is $40, very interesting looking set. Moving forward, we do have the Stark Jet and the Drone Attack. Not too many interesting minifigures. The only ones that I really care about in here is that we do get the updated version of the Nick Fury minifigure in there. Otherwise, nothing really interesting going on in there. The jet does look very interesting, but it's not really my type. Then we have the Avengers Ultimate Quinjet set, which I do own. I do have a review for that down in the description below or the card above. I also have a comparison video to one of the first ever Quinjet sets, which surprisingly actually has a lot of views on it, and I thank you all for that. Moving on down here, we have our last Spider-Man Far From Home set right here, which is the Molten Man Battle for $30. Another big sort of mech set going on right here, but, you know, nothing really too interesting going on. Probably will never get this set. Moving on, we have the last of the LEGO Marvel Avengers Endgame sets, which none of these really correspond with the movie. We have the War Machine Buster, which includes our Ant-Man minifigure as well as War Machine. Very interesting set, but, you know, nothing really too accurate to the main movie that came out. Then we have the Iron Man Hall of Armor set, which is something I'm still considering getting, but, you know, I don't really necessarily need this in my collection for $60. It's a little too expensive. Probably pay, like, about $20 for this. Nothing really too interesting in there for me. Moving on, we have the Avengers Compound Battle, which is probably one of the more accurate sets for, like, the Avengers Endgame movie, though it does include a couple of, like, weird vehicles and stuff in here. The only thing that really makes this set appealing is a Thanos minifigure. Other than that, I don't really care for any of the other stuff that's included within here. But I don't really think I have any plans of picking this up just for the one character. If I want to get just the Thanos minifigure, I will eventually end up getting the older set from Avengers Infinity War that does include him. Then moving on, we have the $20 Captain America Outriders Attack set, which is another very interesting, nice set, which does include the updated Captain America minifigure with that new helmet piece, which, you know, still the printing on the head is just a little disappointing for LEGO, but, you know, that's pretty much all my thoughts for the Avengers stuff. Moving on, we have the LEGO Harry Potter theme, which we do not see any of the new sets on here, which is just very disappointing since they aren't coming out until July 1st. I will be getting all of them, like I said before. I just can't wait to get my hands on all of them. We do have the Aragog Slayer, the Quidditch Match, and the Hogwarts Swamping Willow sets right here on this first page. I do have reviews for all three of these sets down in the description below. Probably not the card above, since I do not have a lot of space for that kind of stuff. I probably will just toss in the playlist, however. We do have the Hogwarts Castle direct-to-consumer, which I do have behind me over there. I don't know if I'm ever going to do a review for this. You know, I just think it's too much of a complicated set for me to review, since I will be talking a lot about it, since there is a lot to cover. in here, which it is definitely like a beautiful set. For $400, this is definitely worth it. And I got this with double VIP points, which I did already spend, which, you know, very, very interesting set, and then four exclusive minifigures that you can get nowhere else. Moving on up here, we do have some other very interesting information. We get some information that LEGO's going to be updating their LEGO shop page, I guess, which is something that I just think is very interesting and something that they have to do since, you know, they want to just change things up every now and then, since we have had the same shop page for like a while now. And also we're getting a huge update to the VIP service, which is something that I just can't wait to see what LEGO has to offer for us. And also they just changed the normal red colors to a bluer color right there, and then we have some more monochromatic type blue minifigures within the LEGO VIP range. Otherwise, I don't really know too much more about it, and I don't know if I'm gonna do another video to cover it. So yeah, that's pretty much all my thoughts for that. Moving on, we do have the Lady Liberty Brickheads right here, the Statue of Liberty Brickheads, which I should be getting in the mail already as of this time. I don't know when I'm gonna be doing my review for this. I probably will end up doing it before July, since I will be using July just to work on all of the LEGO Harry Potter reviews, and I'll be getting those out as soon as possible. But for $10, just normal Brickheads, and also this does confirm that the Brickheads line is somewhat still alive, and we also have some confirmation that we will be getting more Brickheads stuff within the future of 2020, and that does include some licensed Brickheads, which I'm excited to see what we're gonna be getting. Moving on, we have another little Legoland advertisement, as well as some of the LEGO Toy Story 4 sets, which, as you know, these are all 4 Plus, which is a little disappointing. Too many disappointing stuff within this catalog, which I really hate to say that, since I do really like some of these sets as well. We have the Woody and RC car set right here for $10, which I do have my review for that down in the description below, as well as the card above. Then we have some of the other sets. We have the Toy Story 4 RV Vacation set right here, which is the only set to include Forky right there, as well as Jessie. And then you also get Rex right there, which is also very nice. I do actually have an older version of those minifigures though. And then you do get one of the Pizza Planet aliens. We have the Buzz and Woody's Carnival Mania set right here, which is the only sets to include the Duck and Bunny new characters introduced to the Toy Story movie. And then you also get Bo Peep, Woody, and Buzz right there. Still, one thing to complain about is that the printing on the head for the Buzz Lightyear minifigure, they shouldn't be printing those colors on those darker head pieces, since they aren't really coming out very nicely lately. And then we have the Carnival Thrill coaster set for $20 right here with Buzz and the alien character. That pretty much covers up the Toy Story 4 theme. Like I said before, these are all 4 Plus. Wish that they actually sprinkled in some normal sets as well, but otherwise that's pretty much all my thoughts for those. Moving on, we have some LEGO City stuff right here. We have the Downtown Fire Brigade. Most of these are some of the sets that came out back in January. We also have the Burger Bar Rescue Fire set. Looks pretty nice. We have the Sky Police Diamond Heist, as well as a police patrol car for $10. Pretty nice set for 10 bucks. And then you get the Sky Police Parachute Arrest. Wish I could get one of those sets with the parachute, something interesting that I want to try out. And then we have some of the LEGO Friends sets, which we will be getting more of these within August. We have Mia's House, we have Olivia's Cupcake Cafe right there. This set is actually pretty nice. Really like how they just have like that strawberry thing going on right there. We also have Stephanie's Horse Jumping Area right here, which is a $40 set. Very nice. We have Emma's Art Studio, which is another interesting set since it does include that new feature right there with the painting area, which is something pretty cool for a LEGO set. And then we have the 1-4 Plus range set right here, Mia's Fool Stable. Moving forward, we have our last couple sets to look at. We have two sets from LEGO Architecture. We have the San Francisco set, as well as the Paris set, which these both released back in January as well. Don't really care for the LEGO Architecture theme as a whole. Nothing really interests me within this theme. And then finally, we have some LEGO Ideas sets right here. We have the Steamboat Willie, which I do have something that will include some of the pieces from this set that will either come before or after this video releases. This set retails for $90, which I think is just crazily expensive for the set, but based on the piece count, it's worth it, I guess. But, you know, it's just a very small looking set, and then you get a lot of very nice exclusive printed pieces within the set. And then finally, we have the LEGO Flintstones set, which this is a very nice set for $60, though it is missing the kids and also Dino in there. Wish that they did include those, but, you know, I do think that this set does look very beautiful. And I do eventually hope to pick it up if it eventually goes down on clearance or anything. And then that finally brings us all the way to the back of the catalog right here, which I might as well just zoom in. We have the LEGO Stranger Things set, which I did promise that I was going to do a thoughts video on the LEGO Stranger Things set, but I didn't really get too much time to do that. This set retails for $200 and is called the Upside Down, set number 75810. This set includes a lot of very nice minifigures, all the main characters, as well as a very nice plaque for your character's main characters to stand on. This set is just very interesting, like just the building style and everything for it, since it is pretty much the same build, just reversed, since it's like the normal side of the world and then the upside down. You also get Jim Hopper's van right there, his police vehicle, as well as a large amount of printed pieces. And like I said with the LEGO Steamboat Willie set, you guys can look forward to some type of video that's going to be coming out either before or after this featuring some special stuff from this, my bricks and pieces order where I got some interesting parts. So yeah, that pretty much just covers all of the sets within here. It's a little disappointing that the US is not going to be getting any of these summer sets anytime soon. One thing that I am happy about, however, is that the Harry Potter sets are releasing in July, which is something that I'm just looking forward to, since that really is one of the only themes that I've been, like, looking forward to since the start of this year. And even since I bought the last sets, I've been waiting for more LEGO Harry Potter stuff, since I am just such a huge fan of LEGO Harry Potter, and it's just something that I've been looking forward to for a while. One other thing that I just wanted to mention just quickly is that we will not be getting any LEGO Star Wars sets this summer, other than the fact that we might be getting the LEGO Droids Boost set coming in August, I think, or maybe even September or October. I don't really know when that releases. And then finally, we do get our Triple Force Friday stuff for Star Wars, which, you know, that will be releasing when Triple Force Friday actually happens. Otherwise, I'm done with rambling on about all of this stuff. One thing that I just wish is that LEGO, please just release stuff in the same day everywhere in the world in the future. I just think that that would be something that would please a lot of fans, since it is just very annoying, you know, just thinking that like half of the world already has something that you're not gonna get for like maybe like 1 or 2 months. And you know, the wait is just very long. I know that they've done it the opposite way in the past, but you know, it's just something that like, I don't really want to be too negative about this fact, since you know, it has happened before within the US that we haven't gotten stuff before other countries, but this is the first time that it's happened the other way around that I've been a little bit more like unhappy about, since Harry Potter has been my life since they released the sets back in 2018. And I just can't wait to get my hands on it, which, you know, I just keep saying that. Sorry for rambling on too much within this video, but you know, that's really my whole point, that LEGO, if you guys are going to be releasing stuff, why not just wait until you have the products ready for everybody and release it all on the same day for all the countries around the world? So, yeah, that's pretty much all for this video. Remember to like and subscribe and hit that bell icon so every time I upload a new video. So yeah, that's it for now, and I will see you next time. Bye!